Festival is something that I've been doing for about 3 years. I'm Peter Sheldon in the physics department. I'm the chair of the physics department and director of the engineering program. One of the things that I've been trying to do ever since I started teaching is get people excited about science, in particular people who aren't interested in science. So my specialty is really the general public. Not that the general public isn't always interested in science, but trying to get them more interested. So I do a fair number of outreach activities, but one thing that we start that a student started about 7 years ago is Science Day for kids. And we chose 3rd through 6th grade kids only because we were afraid of getting too many kids, so we just thought that was a good age group to get them started in getting interested in science. And what happened after we did Science Day is an afternoon, a Saturday afternoon of hands-on activities for kids. We break them up into groups and they run through activities. And the first year we did it, we had about 70 kids. The second year we did it, we had about 100 kids. We're now up to 250 kids. But what happened is after we did it for about 3 years, the parents and the kids started coming to me and saying, "Oh, I'm so sad, I can't come back to Science Day anymore," which was an amazing feeling. You know, like they've been coming for 3 or 4 years and they can't come back anymore because they're going to graduate to 7th grade.
Right.
And so I decided, okay, I'm just going to bite the bullet and I'm going to make it a whole weekend of activities. We'll keep Science Day on Saturday, and for the rest of the weekend is for all ages.
Okay.
So this is Science Day, which is the Saturday afternoon for kids. We have around 250 kids here today.
Okay.
And so this is just one of the many activities.
And what kind of stuff is going on inside?
So we've got three activities going on in the gym and four activities going on in the science building, or five activities. No, four in the science building and one in the organic garden.
Okay.
So here in the gym, they are building bottle rockets. It's just a 2-liter bottle with a straw, and they're shooting bottle rockets for distance. You know, it's aerodynamics or whatever you want to think of it. The education department has a bunch of booths where they're doing things like electricity, and they have these computer microscopes and just exploration kind of things.
Here at this table, they are experimenting with temperature, different temperature probes. And they're examining what type of water bottle keeps your sports drink the coldest. So that's kind of what one of the questions that they're investigating. The other question that they're investigating is taking a look at how gloves and mittens keep your hands warm. And so it's kind of centered around athletes and sports and using different temperatures and trying to figure out, is a digital thermometer better or a manual thermometer? So they're kind of doing that. Well, they're also creating a graph. So they're learning about how to graph your data and present your data to the general public. So they're talking about that as well.
And then I have a class, which is called Green Engineering Design, where my class learned about how we produce and use energy. And my class is doing an activity where the kids are actually building nuclear reactors, or building nuclear power plants, out of styrofoam and toothpicks. they're learning about nuclear power.
Timing.
And that's why we added that activity at the last minute, just because it was good timing for what's going on in the world right now to educate kids a little bit about nuclear power.
Right now, the kids are working on building a model of a nuclear plant. We already explained to them the basics of a nuclear power plant and how the uranium heats up and boils water into steam and then turns a turbine. They are now each building individual components, and then at the end we'll bring it all together and have a model.
In the science building we have chemistry. The chemistry club is doing, it's called TLC. C stands for chromatography. But it's really cool because they're just basically taking markers and they're doing some kind of reaction or something, and they're just making really cool designs and colors, but it's a chemistry thing. We have Doug Shedd from the biology department. He has a lot of specimens of skulls and dead animals, and he's exploring those with the kids.
My name is Kat Koo, and I'm a volunteer for Science Festival and Science Day. I'm working with Dr. Shedd on the Lynchburg animals. So a lot of the specimens that you see actually here are actual animals, stuffed animals from Lynchburg.
And we have Professor Schenk from Katrin from the physics department is doing something on sound and music. So she's got a whole bunch of musical instruments, and she's got computers that are reading the sound signals and displaying them on screens. And then we have the organic garden, where the organic garden folk are showing the chickens and the ducks and how to compost and things like that. So we have these kids in groups of 25. They go to each of these activities for 30 minutes at a time, and they just rotate through them. And I should also mention we have 90 college student volunteers who are helping run the activities and lead the kids around. This is a big event.